In 1787, while Maine was still part of the state of Massachusetts, George Washington engaged two Masons from the town of Falmouth, modern-day Portland, Jonathan Bryant and John Nichols, and instructed them to take charge of the construction of a lighthouse on Portland Head. Washington reminded them that the early government was poor and said that the materials used to build the lighthouse should be taken from the fields and shores, materials which could be handled nicely when hauled by oxen on drag. The original plans called for a tower to be 58 feet tall. When the Masons completed this task, they climbed to the top of the tower and realized that it would not be visible beyond the headlands to the south, so it was raised another 20 feet. The tower was built of rubble stone, and Washington gave the Masons 4 years to build it. While it was under construction in 1789, the federal government was being formed, and for a while it looked as though the lighthouse would not be finished. Following passage of their ninth law, the first Congress made an appropriation and authorized the Secretary of the Treasury, Alexander Hamilton, to inform the mechanics that they could go on with the completion of the tower. On August 10, 1790, the second session of Congress appropriated a sum not to exceed $1,500, and under direction of the President, to cause the said lighthouse to be finished and completed accordingly. The tower was completed in 1790 and first lit on January 10, 1971. During the American Civil War, raids on ships in and out of Portland Harbor became commonplace. Because of the necessity of ships at sea to sight Portland Head was soon possible, the tower was raised 20 more feet.